Starting goaltenders tonight brought to you by Pizza Hotline's Hockey Meal Deal. Order tonight and save big. Andrei Pavlik, game number 201. He is now three shy of the franchise mark set by Kari Lehtinen. It is Cam Ward who was the goaltender for the Stanley Cup champion Carolina Hurricanes the year that Andrew Ladd was a champion here. He gets the start and goal for Carolina.
We talked about in the opening, Dennis, Ryan Murphy on the emergency recall out of the OHL, and no easing him in. He's not going to get to watch for a few minutes. Right out there, opening lineup, playing with Eric Staal, number one line, up against Evander Kane on the other side. Welcome to the NHL.
May as well get the nerves out of the way right off the bat, and he sends it up on the left side for Tolusti. Tolusti ahead for Semin. Semin's quick shot is stopped by Pavlik, and Oliokinen turns it back up, almost turned it over. In fact, he does turn it over. Cross-ice pass, that gets picked off, and the Jets will start back. Gets out to center where Evander Kane will track it down. Referees tonight, Dan O'Rourke and Justin St. Pierre. The linesmen are Greg Dvorsky and Donnie Henderson. Carolina, Staal for Harrison. That would be Jordan Staal. There's two of them in the lineup now. Hainsey gets this out to center ice, and as it's brought back in by Jordan Staal, we are going to have offside. Tonight's game plan brought to you by Tim Hortons Premium Blend Coffee, always 20 minutes fresh.
And for Winnipeg, it's all about getting the Carolina defense to turn, whether it's skating it wide and deep or putting pucks in behind them, trying to get them play below their goal line, take advantage of some of their injuries and some of their youth. And for Carolina, you saw right off the opening faceoff, speed through the neutral zone, slashing guys, looking for lanes, looking to score off the rush.
Jamie McBain, Tim Gleason, and Joni Pitkinen all missing from the back end for the Hurricanes. Antropov stopped there by Joe Corvo. Antropov will gather it in, sends it for Paul Postma. He'll leave it for Stewart. For Burmistrov, he tried to get it out, could not. Snap back in from that right side by Tim Wallace. And controlled by Postma. Turned over in front of the net, and Pavlik got a piece of that. Centered in front, Pavlik, a save on the short side. What a couple of chances for the Hurricanes. Wallace with the first one. Pavlik looks like he just got a piece of it. Up the middle, Antropov deflects this in. Ward stops it off the backboards. Played ahead by Corvo. Jordan Staal gently slides it in. After it, Grayson Bowman to the backboard. Staal there to help out. He's tied up by a couple of Jets. Trying to get it as Klitsam sends it ahead. Right side boards, tight quarters there. Grayson Bowman tying up Wheeler, and now Wheeler comes up with it. He'll find Ladd, who'll find Wheeler. Some room, and Ice scores! Blake Wheeler, the wrist shot from the right side, beats Cam Ward, and the Winnipeg Jets score early again and lead 1-0.
That's what Blake Wheeler was looking for, and this is the strong play on the wall. He doesn't turn it over, keeps it in his feet, wins the battle, and then gets his leg moving, touches in the middle, gets it back to the outside while he strings it out, and this is a shot that Cam Ward has to save, but Blake Wheeler will take it off the bar and in. Nice wrist there, big smile as that one was due, but the play was made right there, winning the battle, moving the puck, and then moving his feet. Quick wrister from a distance. Cam Ward's reaction tells you everything you know about the quality of that goal, but good habits in defensive zone leading to the rush opportunity for Blake Wheeler.
And Mike, that came after you had a better view of it than I did. Did Andrei Pavlik get a piece of the Wallace chance?
He absolutely did, and that was a egregious turnover, but that's the wall play you don't need to make in the middle. Nick Antropov tried it. Blake Wheeler does it right, gets a chance going the other way.
Bouncing puck out at center, 1-0 in favor of the Jets. So after Brian Little gave the Jets the lead 1 minute into the game in Buffalo, 1:53 into this one, they open the scoring, and they have now scored first in four of the last six games. An area that they really struggled in early, and now we're going to have the game's first penalty.
That's Mikhail Jourdain putting his hand over the puck. He didn't brush it along the ice. We've seen a lot of this, Dennis, and it's hard for guys to remember that they cannot put their hand over top of the puck. And Jourdain, another young guy, gets bumped off the puck. Good forecheck by Thorburn, and he puts it on right there, scrapes it back into Thorburn's feet, and all the bets on the Carolina Hurricanes shake their, all the coaches shake their head on the bench, and Jourdain hits the box.
So power play for the Winnipeg Jets, and an area they have not been able to get a lot of work on simply because they don't draw a lot of penalties. And the power play does go to work. This is only the 52nd power play opportunity the Jets have had this season. Only Colorado, Dallas, and Boston are below them in that category.
That speaks to how much you play with the puck. When you have the puck under your possession, you force the other teams to take penalties. The Jets need to do more of that.
So Blake Wheeler snaps a six-game goalless drought, has the Jets in front, and the Jets go in on the power play. Ladd plays it behind the net, and we saw a little bit of this in the only power play they had in Buffalo. Dustin Byfuglien down low, and Olli Jokinen at the point. Little for Bogosian. Back for Little. Watched by Jordan Staal. To the goal line for Ladd, and back for Bogosian. Bogosian looking for a lane, fires it, Byfuglien in front, and Ward got a piece of it. Ladd for Jokinen. Played the point when he was in Florida. Jokinen for Bogosian and back for Jokinen. Drills it from the line. That goes off a leg and wide. Little gets it for Ladd. For Bogosian. Jokinen back for Bogosian. Fakes over to Ladd. Shot right on. Byfuglien in front. Couldn't get a stick on that loose puck. Controlled by Ladd. Back for Jokinen. Shot right on. Scramble in front. Loose puck. And it's cleared. Grabbed on the right side, and Patrick Dwyer will get it down the ice.
Well, you see exactly what Byfuglien in front of the net can do, distracting both Faulk and Harrison. He's so big, they can't push him out of the way, and they have to work to get around him to find those loose pucks, allowing Little and Ladd to corral him.
Mike, that is the best the Jets' power play has looked in a while.
Absolutely, several good looks, and Jokinen and Bogosian doing a nice job. There you see the goal scorer, Blake Wheeler. I love him moving the puck to the middle, spacing it out, drawing Harrison in the middle, creating his own ice off the bar and in. And earlier, this is not what you want to do. We highlighted Wheeler doing the right thing. That is Antropov doing the wrong thing. That was tape to Wallace, and Pavlik had to do well to get off his line and get set on what would have been a surprise play.
So the Jets have had three games now where they have scored in the opening 2 minutes, and all of those on the road. Chris Thorburn, 1:58 into the game in Boston, and then Brian Little, 1 minute into the game in Buffalo on Tuesday, and now Blake Wheeler, 1:53 in, has the Jets in front. Three shots on that power play for the Winnipeg Jets. Bermistra drags it on the backhand, tried to get it up front. Kane is on the loose puck. Kane riding a four-game point streak. For Bermistra, and back for Kane. Tight quarters, though, in the Carolina zone, and the veteran Joe Corvo, in his third go-around with Carolina, sends it for Talusti. Slides it in, and Andre Pavlik is going to put the big mitt on this and hold it.
Dustin Byfuglien, he played some power play time in front of the net back when he was with Chicago, and he is just such a big man. Justin Falk doesn't even bother to try to engage him, lets him stand there, and just distracts E. Ward having to search, trying to fight through C pucks, and then Harrison trying to help out, drawing his attention. He's not even feeling those little taps in the ankle from Falk. He can release, he can make plays, but because he's so big, it takes up all the attention of the one net front D. In that case, a little bit from Harrison as well, and he's got the good enough skills to handle pucks down in and around tight, as he did with the Blackhawks on their cup run.
We've talked about the Jets' trouble scoring in the opening period. That is the Jets' ninth first period goal. Carolina has only scored six first period goals, although they have had a lot of road games. This is only their sixth home game of the young season. Yes, young season, despite the fact we're well into February. Back in his own end for Carolina, Riley Nash, one of the call-ups because of the injuries. Talked about the defenseman missing, Tim Brent, Jeff Skinner. Tuomo Ruutu is yet to play this year for Carolina. Down low, a chance off the goalpost. As LaRose, another turnover by the Winnipeg Jets at the line. Slap shot, that gets blocked. And Wright is there to send this back into the Carolina zone, but this is going to be an icing call.
Another turnover, you called it, Dennis, and another bad one. They do a breakaway for Chad LaRose, albeit from the hash marks down. And he has Pavlik beat on the quick release. Right there, a little soft play in the middle, good defensive position. Nice little saucer pass from Westgarth. And the quick release from LaRose, who's been snake bit, had a tough start to his season this year. They expect more goals out of him than they've gotten. And he rings the iron behind Pavlik. Pavlik reading 5-hole, trying to go paddle down, and LaRose fooled him with a shot to the blocker side.
Just one goal on the season for Chad LaRose. Going in to take the faceoff will be Tim Wallace, who had a great scoring opportunity early in this game as well, as we look at Chad LaRose. Slater, who won that big faceoff in Buffalo on Tuesday, can't win this one. Clear around the boards, Andreas Nodal tracks it down to the line. That is kept in, cross ice by Jourdain. And finally, the Jets do control in their own zone. Looking for a line change, though, after that icing call. They're going to try and jam it in front for Jokinen, and couldn't get a shot away. Another chance in behind the Jets defense. That's off a skate and a good save by Andrei Pavlik. And now slapped down the ice by Kyle Wellwood as the Jets are going to try and get themselves regrouped. They won't be able to get the complete line change in as James Wright is still out there.
Andrei Pavlik has been busy so far. I want to say 5 shots on goal. They've all been good quality. Another soft play at the far blue, the blue line. Quick transition. Postma can't be going paddle down there. He's got to stay in the middle of the ice, giving up Jokinen into the middle. He overskates it.
Scoring chances, 7-2 in favor of Carolina. Jokinen finds Bufflin. He'll wind his way into the Carolina zone. He tries a sharp angle chance, and that goes off the stick of Ryan Murphy, up and out of play.
And Claude Noel had his work cut out for him today, trying to get his team prepared for this game after what happened to Zach Redman in the morning skating. They've gotten out to the 1-0 lead, which he'll be happy about, but he will not be happy with their puck management in their own end. There's been some turnovers, some soft plays, some battles lost. And you see another broken play. Nodal bats this one out of the air, a little deflection. And Pavlik has had to be very sharp early on to keep this game a 1-0 lead. You see Nodal couldn't quite get that ricochet shot through Pavlik's feet. He's been sharp. The team in front of him, not so much in their own end.
Andreas Nodal still looking for his first goal of the season.
Well, a lot of guys down in the Carolina's third and fourth line are looking to get a little bit more going offensively. They've been carried by the top two. Not much support from the depth lines.
Bufflin down low, back up the boards. Bufflin pinches in, shot past him by Grayson Bowman. And back for it, Grant Klitsam. For Eric Tangrady. Tangrady will get this to the Carolina line, no further. Ryan Murphy sends it up at center. Now there's a penalty coming to the Jets. It's going to be Grant Klitsam who goes off for pulling the feet up from under Jordan Staal.
It's a good call. Right in front of me, Dennis, Grant Klitsam. Trying to play defense heading forward, and that is a very difficult thing to do, especially with someone as big and as strong as Jordan Staal. Murphy, quick up here. Jordan Staal skates into it. Grant Klitsam overskates it, and he's in trouble right there. Has to take the feet out, and that's not a bad penalty to take for Grant Klitsam. That was going to be a 3-on-1. He doesn't bring Jordan Staal down, so that little bobble in a tough spot, you'd be harder on that puck. Just slam it back in the zone if you're unsure of handling it.
Cleared to the line, but not out. Now on a second chance, it will get sent out to center. Carolina's power play operating at just under 17%. Better here at home. Jiří Tlusty, who was the NHL's third star of the week, clears it in, but it's fired right back down the ice by Vermistrov.
I'd like to see Ryan Murphy right out here, first power play unit in his first game. Kirk Muller giving him every opportunity to be successful. This is what he's good at. This is why he will be in the NHL.
He had 3 points at the World Junior Championships in Ufa, Russia, and his one goal did come on the power play. Now it's turned over, grabbed off by Brian Little. He tried to drag it around. The defenseman could not, in the Hurricanes start back. Semin in on that right side, watched by Brian Little. Down for Staal, in for Eric Staal. This goes off his stick and bounces its way out to center. Tlusty leaves it there for Semin. Semin tried to get around, Vermistrov could not. And on the puck is Zach Bogosian, and he'll rattle it off the boards and back out to center, where Evander Kane will redirect it into the Carolina zone. Back forward, Alexander Semin, signed as an unrestricted free agent after 7 years in Washington. And ahead for Jussi Jokinen. Slides it down low, Jokinen heads to the front of the net, and that pass redirected and into the netting in behind Andrei Pavlik.
You think power plays would have the advantage heading into tonight's game, as these teams are last and second last in penalty killing at 68% is abysmal, quite frankly. That is not a good number. I know it's early on, smaller sample size, but the Jets have to get so much better than that, as do the Canes. You can't have to be able to rely on your penalty kill to kill off important power plays at key times in the games. Jets have been getting better at the last few games, have to continue to improve.
They were 3-for-3 against Buffalo on Tuesday, and if you go back the last seven games, 80% in that time frame, but still a costly one against the Boston Bruins at home last Sunday. Bogosian, far side board, gets tied up by a couple of Hurricanes, but Antropov is on the loose puck, gets it to James Wright, and James Wright will slide this back, and Joe Corvo will have to backtrack. Corvo on the power play with Grant, puts him in the penalty box. Room on the left side for Riley Nash, the wrist shot off the blocker of Pavlik, and onto the stick of Dustin Byfuglien, and quickly back out to center ice and into the Carolina zone. Two shots on that power play for Carolina. Byfuglien after it with Andreas Nodal. They take each other to the corner boards. Byfuglien the aggressor. Wheeler to center ice. He gets tripped up on the play and right back in for Chad LaRose. The shot off of Byfuglien to the corner. Nodal behind the net, tied up by Ron Hainsey. Hainsey trying to work it off the boards. Gets some help there from Burmistrov. On for Blake Wheeler, and Wheeler off a leg and out the center. 1-0 Jets on the early goal from Blake Wheeler. Jay Harrison for Ryan Murphy. Ryan Murphy's pass was in behind Andreas Nodal. And the Hurricanes start a line change. That will give Byfuglien some time.
You can almost see Murphy thinking there. And the OHL, he'll probably take that puck and try to skate it through the neutral zone.
Evander Kane wide on Murphy. Kane in the corner. Jokinen to the right point for Zach Bogosian. Zach Bogosian looking for the big bounce off the backboards. It didn't come. And that'll get some room there for Yuri Talusti. For Ryan Murphy. Now Murphy heads to the front of the net. In the slot for Eric Staal. Good job defensively there by Jokinen. And now Semin gets dumped on the play by Tangrady. The play goes on as Tangrady chases Jordan all the way back into his own end.
It's a good back check from Jokinen. Picking up the fourth guy. Three on two. Kept his feet moving for that fourth man.
Kyle Wellwood, one of three Jets to get three goals against the Hurricanes in the season series last year. For Tangrady, to the point now for Bogosian. He'll fire this off a leg, and wide as Talusti got in front of it. Wellwood's after it in the corner. Trying to work it free for Jokinen. Picked up and clear, but Talusti couldn't get it against the checking of Tangrady. Jokinen to Wellwood, he tried to redirect. Didn't get enough on it. As Jokinen, a pretty good spot to fire it. Hainsey back in his own end.
He's trying to find Wellwood's stick down in front for the quick tip. Almost connected.
Bogosian's pass rattles off a leg. Jets will try it again. Wheeler ahead for Ladd. Back for Wheeler. Brian Little heads to the high slot. Wheeler puts it to the front of the net off the stick of Ladd. Mark Stewart throws it. Save rebound. Oh, what a save by Cam Ward off Brian Little with that left pad to keep this a one-goal game. Postma, watch there by Drayson Bowman. Up for Wheeler. Left side for Stewart. Stewart bumping at the line. As he goes shoulder to shoulder with Justin Fulk. Deflected in by Brian Little. Jets start a line change. Jordan on that right side to the line. It's picked off. Burmistrov snaps it on another save by Ward. Burmistrov tight turns, falls, and the puck taken and cleared into the center ice area by Tim Wallace. So the Jets, after giving the Hurricanes some early chances, with some chances of their own. Long pass for Antropov, that misses, and this is going to be icing as Bobby Sanguinetti goes back to touch it.
Well, after taking the first 6 minutes to ease their way into this game, turning pucks over, now it's the Jets jumping on loose pucks, creating turnovers. Mark Stewart, great shot here. Far pad, forced the rebound, and what an unbelievable second save by Cam Ward. That is some quick feet. Taking a sure goal away from Brian Little, and those are the ones you remember. It's a 1-0 game. That makes it 2-0, changes the complexion. And mark that one down as a one that keeps his team in it.
Kane in the corner, battling with Murphy. Alexander Semin is on the loose puck. Kane is after him, out at center to Talusti. takes the pass to Lusty, sharp angle chance. Eric stalls in after a loose puck, gets away from him, and that allows Kane to take it. Kane out for Burmistrov. He'll leap for Antropov, who will find Bogosian. Bogosian's shot goes off Jay Harrison's stick, and Ryan Murphy, the 19-year-old, is there to take it, and he'll settle it down in behind his own net. That will allow the Hurricanes to get their line change in. Harrison to center and pumps this into the Winnipeg zone. Puts him, ties his man up. Thorbert ties his man up, and Wright will send Slater away. Slater over skates it, puts on the brakes, still has trouble with a bouncing puck, finally does get it in deep. Thorburn's in with a forecheck hit out at center, but turned over. Wright didn't touch it, or else it would have been offside. Back in for Riley Nash, sends it in, and Bufflin up the boards. Nash breaks it up. Quickly on Nash was Thorburn. Nash trying to find an open man. Couple of Jets converge on him. Thornton back for Bufflin, and Bufflin will just flip this high in the air and back into the Carolina end.
Now that's not impressive. That's a better job for the Jets in their own end, keeping the puck along the boards, making the ugly play until you get it back, instead of forcing it up the middle as they were earlier in the game.
Paul Postma's pass, that got blocked. Postma turns 22 tomorrow to center ice for Jokinen, and he'll backhand it in where Tangrady goes after Ryan Murphy. Corvo behind his own net. Corvo will play it for Jordan Staal. At first for Drayson Bowman through center. Bowman watched there by Postma. Tangrady around the boards. Ryan Murphy waits for it. Slap shot to the front, deflected. And another save by Andre Pavlik. Wellwood for Mark Stewart. At center for Jokinen, and his cross ice pass is stopped. Second try, he'll get it, but not deep. Quickly turned up by Ryan Murphy for Jordan Staal. Staal watched by Zach Bogosian. Bogosian jams it behind his own net for Hainsey. Hainsey plays it up. Wheeler takes a look and finds Little. Back for Wheeler. Down is offside with Ladd. Drops it back. Bogosian, the shot taken into the midsection by Ward, and he'll hang on. Blake Wheeler has the goal. Little had a chance, but it stays 1-0.
Andre Pavlik, fresh off a very strong game in the win against Buffalo, has come out sharp in the first period. And he's had to be. The first 5-6 minutes, some turnover for the Jets, forcing Pavlik to be at his athletic best, fighting off these secondary opportunities. A lot of tips and loose pucks, stuff bouncing around in front of the net. He's been very good, moving it well, tracking the puck well, fighting through the crowds to make sure that he's out where he needs to be. And it has been an important start for Andre Pavlik, because this game could have gotten away from the Jets early on had he not been as good as he was.
Last six games, Andre Pavlik, a .908 save percentage and a point or a 2.24 goals against average. So, and finally has brought his goals against average for the season below three at 2.96.
Well, they hope that's trending and continues to trend downward. He wants that down closer to 2.5 or lower, as the team in front of him also needs to tighten up. He's faced a few too many good opportunities.
Little to face off along with Jussi Jokinen. Out to center for Nodal. For Jokinen. In the middle, Wallace tried to get it back to Nodal. That didn't work. Bounces out to center. Nodal is on it. On him is Wheeler. Little is there as well. And back to the Jets line where Dustin Bufflin takes it. For Wheeler, and Wheeler will redirect this in. And Cam Ward will come out and stop it behind his own net, leave it for Joe Corvo. Corvo slowly out of his own end. Feeds it for young Justin Falk, and he'll send it in. Wallace is after it, Clitsam is after him, but offside called against Carolina.
Well, Winnipeg struggled on the road last year, has been much better throughout the early part of this season, and part of being good on the road is being ready to go early on. This is very early in the Buffalo Sabre game. They get Brian Little on board, and again tonight, Blake Wheeler early on. This one, getting that early lead is good for the obvious reason that you have the lead, but also takes the crowd out of it, takes some of the energy out of the building. You don't feel like you're chasing the game. It allows your team to settle in, give yourself some margin for error.
Hainsey back into his own end with Semin after him. Nice pass by Hainsey for Burmistrov. Burmistrov will just send it out to center ice. Ryan Murphy's pass gets gobbled up. Burmistrov back for Bogosian. Another turnover as Hainsey's cross-ice pass deflects off a stick. Bogosian has to cover up. Evander Kane now gathers it in. Kane's pass is off a stick and off a leg, and Skase stays in the Jets' end of the ice. Plenty of time on that pass, but into the skates of Burmistrov. Kane will try it again. Kane takes the shot, goes wide. Kane centers, and it got jammed away before Antropov could get a stick on it. Back for Drayson Bowman. Lets the shot go. Pavlik to save. Rebound to the front of the net, and that got cleared away by Stewart. Antropov for Bufflin. Rink wide to center. Jets starting a change. Kane gets it to the Carolina line. No further. Deflected in, and Pavlik will snap it around the boards. Jordan Staal is there to stop it. Staal gets it down low. Back to the line it comes. Dwyer getting it for Jourdain. Back to the line. Another shot by Jourdain. That's off the stick and almost onto the stick of Drayson Bowman. Now waiting for it is James Wright. He'll chip it through, and after it goes Slater. Thorburn heads to the front of the net. Wright is on the puck. James Wright behind the net, watched by Jordan Staal. Swings it back for Slater. He's got Thorburn in front. Slater tried to get it into the slot to Wright. Wright, good job to get it back to the line, and the Jets control. Sent back down low. Ward blocked it off the backboards, and Jordan Staal will play it behind his own net for Sanguinetti. 1-0 Jets here in the opening period. Bobby Sanguinetti, the former Ranger pick, sends this through, and it gets deflected deep by Kevin Westgaard. Bogosian behind the net trying to tie his man up. Could not. Controlled by the Hurricanes at the line for Corvo from LaRose. Back down low. Nash trying to find a little bit of room. To the line to Corvo. To the right point. Picked off by Wellwood. Wellwood lead pass down to Jokinen. And offside as the puck was bouncing before Jokinen could gain control of it.
Milestone game for Andrew Ladd, the captain, 500th game in the NHL, back where it all started, drafted fourth overall with Carolina. He won a cup here back in 06. He's celebrating Coach Pierre Laviolette. Of course, the team photo was a great start to what's been a very good career. Won another cup in Chicago as well. There he is. Even back then, could he get a good beard going? And you see his stats with Carolina there. Energy player, role player, but cup winner, and that's all he really cares about.
Exactly, and that was the first of two. When you win it in your rookie year, sometimes you think you may not get the opportunity. Well, not only did he get the opportunity, he won another one, that one with Chicago. Interesting thing about the draft, you mentioned where he was picked. The draft was here in Carolina as well. Backhanded by Andrew Ladd, that ends up in the Hurricanes bench. Leads the team in scoring, tied now with Toby Enstrom with 13 points. His 8 goals does lead the team, obviously, in that category.
Great lesson to learn when you look at him and how he scores his goals and goes to hard areas, fights for loose pucks and space before he gets those loose pucks. And you know, a lot of guys in Jets could look at that and try to replicate it.
Corvo behind his own goal. Starts slowly with a pass for Justin Falk to center ice. That gets stopped there by Bogosian on a second try. It gets sent deep by Semin. Taken by Hainsey. Semin almost picks Hainsey's pocket. Erik Staal trying to get it back to Semin. Semin the back pass. Score! Jiří Tlusti. On a great back pass from Semin. And the Hurricanes tie the game with 1:21 left in the period.
Tlusti with the goal, Semin with the pass, the turnover there, a little hesitation by Hainsey, not sure where to go with it, has his pocket picked, but how about this pass around the back, right on the tape for Jiří Tlusti. What a feed by Alex Semin, gets it done defensively right here, turning it over for Ron Hainsey, takes it, drives the net, and then splits Bogosian in front of Wheeler, who can't get back to Tlusti for the easy finish, and Tlusti has been the recipient of a couple nice passes as of late. Alex Semin, what a feed.
So the turnovers in the opening period finally catch up to the Winnipeg Jets, and we have a 1-1 tie. Through center ice for Kane. Tried to jam it through for Antropov. Stalls lost his stick. That allows the Jets to keep it in the Carolina zone. Through center where Bufflin breaks it up, plays this back on that right side. It gets away from Bermie Strott. Jay Harrison did back in behind the net for Bufflin. And Bufflin for Bermie Strott. Finds a little bit of room through center right. Sixth of the year for Yuri Tulusky. After Wheeler's fifth of the year, had the Jets in front. Mike, you talked about Eric Staal having his point streak snapped. Well, he started another one with the assist on that goal along with Semin.
They talked about Semin being a better passer than they anticipated, and I guess evidence right there is that was a sick little behind-the-back pass in traffic right on the tape.
Puts him from Bogosian. Wright will deflect this to the Carolina blue line, and one period comes to an end here in Carolina, with each team capitalizing on some turnovers and a 1-1 tie after 20 minutes. Wheeler for the Jets, Tulusky for the Hurricanes, 1-1 here in Carolina. Second period about to get underway. There's the stats from the opening period. Wheeler early at 1:53 from Andrew Ladd, who's in his 500th NHL game, and then Yuri Tulusky late in that period from Semin and Eric Staal. Shots were 10-8 in favor of Carolina.
Tulusky finally beat Andre Pavlik, who was very good in that first period, and he had to be. We highlighted some of those turnovers. He was alert, sharp in the game, moving well, fighting through traffic. And I'm sure the guys in the dressing room between periods said, thank you very much. We'll be better in front of you so you don't have to face those same kind of opportunities here into the second period.
Tulusty and Pavlik, both from the Czech Republic. Second period underway here in Carolina. Semin fires the long shot in, rolling puck, and that ends up into the netting.
We talked to Kurt Muller this morning, and he was telling us about Alex Semin, how well he's fit in here, how the guys have really had him, enjoyed having him around. And the thing that surprised Kurt Muller was that Semin is a better passer and playmaker than they thought he was. Everyone assumes with that wrist shot that he's a natural shooter, but that has not been his inclination, and Eric Staal is enjoying playing with a guy who's as skilled a puck as Semin has been in this early part of the season.
Zach Bogosian for Blake Wheeler, out there with Ladd and Little, who leads the Jets in the plus-minus department at +5, sends it in, and after it goes Ladd. Eric Staal takes it for Carolina, for Semin. Semin will slow it down through center and then flip it in on Pavlik, and with Yuri Tulusty there, Pavlik's going to hang on to it.
Semin raised some eyebrows when he signed here, 1 year, $6 million deal, but we know he's an unbelievably good offensive player when he is engaged. He has one of the best releases. Always the comment out of Washington was that he could shoot the puck better than Alex Ovechkin, and right there is the one that he could do like virtually nobody else in the NHL. But he's been more than just the shot this year for Carolina. He's been a setup guy. His plus minus is very good. Along with Eric Staal, he's been getting it done 5-on-5. So all they're hoping for right now out of Alex Semin in what is a contract year.
6 minutes and 22 seconds of ice time for Semin in this game. One assist, a couple of shots on goal, and what a sweet pass that assist was. Back pass to Yuri Tulusty. Wellwood in his own zone for Bufflin. That pass for Tangrady misses, and Ryan Murphy in the game tonight, up on emergency recall, as the Hurricanes banged up both on the back end and up front. Jordan Staal, pass up the middle to Ryan Murphy. To the line, had trouble with a rolling puck. On it, Dwyer. Dwyer leaves it there for Drayson Bowman. To the line for Jay Harrison. He couldn't fire it. Dwyer and Bufflin to the far side boards. Ryan Murphy in from the line, jams it down low. Puts him taken to the back boards. Bufflin tried to get it for Tangrady, and now redirected for Olli Jokinen. Jokinen for Klitson, who joins the rush. He can fire it, and he does, looking for that high glove corner, and Cam Ward picks it off.
Grant Klitson joining the rush, creating the odd man opportunity, and right from his own end, he gets on his horse here from the front of the net. Nice play from Tangrady, little touch pass. Jokinen gets it over, and Klitson's got a little bit more space. Harrison was really good to protect the middle of the ice, and probably could have improved his angle by a couple feet. challenge Cam Ward a bit more.
Vermistroff was going to face off against Jussi Jokinen. Jokinen gets waved out.
We've seen way more of that this year, Dennis, haven't we? Guys
yes.
get kicked out of the faceoff circle.
Vermistroff goes in to take it with Wallace.
He's getting a little frustrated exactly what they can and cannot do heading in there.
Kept in by Wallace. Wallace will try and send this down low. Back to the right point. Screenshot by Justin Falkwin over top the net. Joe Corvo on the far side. Vermistroff is trying to get it out. Can't. Nodal sends it back down low. Pressure here by the Hurricanes. In behind the net. 1-1 tie here in the second period. Back to the line for Justin Falk. Falk swings it cross ice to Corvo. Off a leg into the slot and a bouncing puck and a save by Andre Pavlik. We are back at it Saturday here on TSN Jets as the Jets in Philadelphia to take on the Flyers. May we see another 9-8 game like we did last year.
Oh.
Live coverage begins here on TSN Jets and TSN 1290, 1130 Central.
Oh, we can only hope, Dennis. 9-8, it would be a dream game for us.
Wow.
Not for him, though, as Andre Pavlik makes another save on Tim Wallace.
Pavlik got pulled in that game. Chris Mason got hurt. Pavlik came back in.
Got the win.
Yep. Andrew Ladd late in that game with the game winner.
That was one of the wildest games of the year last year. Hockey has just not played that way anymore, but when you win it, it doesn't matter.
Well, Pittsburgh and Philly tried to do it again last night.
Did they ever? No worries about Philly. That brings out the worst in Pitt.
Riley Nash plays it behind the net. Chad LaRose trying to jam it out front. That got stopped. James Wright is on it. Wright dodged the check as Westgarth came in and tried to bump Wright. And now the puck taken by Ron Hainsey. Chad LaRose closes in on Hainsey quickly. And it's out to center Sanguinetti. There for the Hurricanes and right back into the Winnipeg zone. Sanguinetti, the wrist shot. Glove saved by Pavlik. And Pavlik is going to hang on to that.
Well, Bobby Sanguinetti. Also rusher. Hainsey clears it out. That's a good hard play, but right here, Thorburn on a flyby. You have to finish him. Can't let him just turn up and walk right in. Numbers coming back, forcing Pavlik to make a save. Another defensive zone faceoff. And you keep playing in your own end. Goals against, penalties. Bad things happen when you defend all night.
Especially when you don't have the last change. Andrew Ladd. Tries to get this in deep, it bounces around, and this is going to be called a glove pass as it ends up on the stick of Blake Wheeler.
You make a good point there, Dennis, because you don't have last change. You put out your defensively reliable guys, and those guys start getting worn out because Claude Noel now has to put out Little every single time, put out Slater every single time, because that's who we trust to take defensive zone faceoffs. The other lines don't get the ice they need. Evander Kane doesn't get to get out there and get his shifts, and the bench becomes disjointed.
Starts with face-offs, and the Hurricanes have won 16 of 24 in this game. Semin plays it to the right point. Corvo tees it up, and Pavlik got a piece of that. Bogosian for Wheeler. Wheeler for Little and back for Wheeler. Trying to barge his way in, gets knocked down there by Corvo. Brian Little's after the loose puck. Little falls in behind the net. Wheeler goes back after Corvo. And Andrew Ladd gets the puck at center. For Grant Klitsam. Klitsam has to wait for Wheeler to get onside and fires it all the way around the boards. Jiří Tlusti clears it out. Here comes Eric Staal. Staal with some room and Grant Klitsam closed off on him quickly and prevented Staal from getting the shot away. And we're going to have a penalty to the Jets.
I mean, unsportsmanlike on Blake Wheeler. He wasn't happy. He thought he took a high stick on the rush by Joe Corvo and he laid in to Dan O'Rourke. For the better part of 20 seconds, didn't even get back engaged the play, was slow getting off, and that is a tough one to take here. 1-1. You don't want to put your team down just because you're a little bit frustrated. You understand he did get his, I think, a glove up in the chin on the rush, puts his team in a bad spot.
Face off to the right of Pavlik, Slater and Jordan Staal to face off. Jets come up with it. And Mark Stewart will try and get it out of his own zone. Blocked there by Nash and kept in by Falk. Cross ice to Corvo and Slater went down to block it. Slater now trying to jam it out. Finally does get it out to center ice.
What a good block that was by Jim Slater. Timed the slide perfectly, taking all the shooting angles away.
Sent right back into the Winnipeg zone. Stahl tried to get it to Riley Nash. Broken stick on the play. Turned over. Chance to the short side. Save made as Corville picked off that pass from Hainsey. His clearing attempt. Cross ice feed now for Jokinen. Away from him, Mark Stewart. Back for Hainsey. Nice pass by Hainsey to get it to Wright. James Wright will get it down the ice. Mark Stewart making his way to the bench. Interesting how it worked out. Mark Stewart's 400th game last Sunday was against the team that drafted, or that was Boston. And tonight, it is Andrew Ladd's 500th game against the team that drafted him. And the Jets are going to be down two men.
Now, the players are struggling with this call, Dennis. We've seen it all year long. It's that interference call as defensemen rub out forwards after they chip the puck in behind them. They have to be engaged with the player while he's chipping in. There cannot be any separation. You see LaRose chip it in, and Clitson just finish him off here. And it has been a difficult adjustment for players to make. It's just that little separation. If they're 5 feet closer, he can finish that check. But at 5-6 feet of space, which that play has been commonplace for several years in the NHL, no longer allowed. And that's a tough one to take, 5-on-3 for 55 seconds here for Carolina.
For the fifth time this season, the Jets are down two men. They had yet to kill one off. And it's controlled by Talusti. For Jordan Stahl. For Eric Stahl. Corville. At the line, Semin. Plays it down low. Sharp angle chance. Save made by Pavlik, and he'll hang on as Justin Falk with the sharp angle shot.
And not the typical alignment. You have two forwards playing the point. You got Justin Falk down on the goal line. He's trying to sling this one across back door. And Pavlik with the active stick. Not only stops the pass, but freezes it. Bounces up in his chest before it gets over to Talusti.
Slater and Jordan Stahl. And two fake starts there, and now it was not dropped fairly. Wow.
Donnie Henderson points at himself, says that one is on him. No face-off violation for either team.
So the referee's now trying to direct some traffic. Semin, as Slater gets on him quickly. Stewart closes it off. Good play there by Stewart, and clear down the ice by Slater.
What a good read by Mark Stewart there. Pressure on the faceoff. Teams were not ready for it and got the clear.
Semin leads the 5-on-3 for Carolina. Gets tied up on the boards. Hainsey is on it. Tried to get it back up to Stewart. Stopped by Jordan Stahl. Stahl off a skate for Semin. Watched by Stewart. For Eric Stahl. For Talusti. Talusti back for Eric Stahl for Semin. And that got blocked by Stewart, and that hurt. Kept in by Eric Stahl. For Semin. Semin down to the goal line, and Hainsey blocked that cross-ice pass from Talusti. Wheeler out of the penalty box. Shot that gets blocked by Mark Stewart. Just one man now down for the Jets. Eric Stahl in front of the net, scramble, and it comes to the far side, and Falk fired it wide. Semin for Eric Stahl, for Justin Falk. Back for Semin. Watched by Wheeler. Back for Falk, watched by Stewart. Shot by Jordan Stahl, and that may have gone off the right pad of Pavlik. Up the boards for Blake Wheeler, and he'll get it down the ice. And Grant Clitson standing up in the box with 20 seconds left. This is going to be an icing call as Hainsey gets back to touch.
Well, what an unbelievable clear as Mark Stewart getting some repairs. He took that first shot, like, oh, it's up in his arm. He's drawn some blood. And he's likely to have to head to the dressing room. He's a warrior. He's going to hang in there. But got it right there just below the cuff of his elbow pad. You can see the blood trickling into his jersey, the pats in the back. This is not easy. That's one where he got up high. It was the one prior to that where he dropped down a little bit lower. The same Alex Semin one-timer. And takes a lot of guts to hang in there. Mark Stewart does it better than most.
Five block shots on the night for Mark Stewart, and that one did some damage. In behind LaRose, plays it for Eric Stahl. After it is Andrew Ladd, up for Little. Little trying to clear the zone out of the penalty box. Now is Klitzelman. Here comes Bufflin. Bufflin drops it back for Ladd. Ladd walks in, goes short side. That missed. Eric Staal to the line, kept in. Can the Jets build some momentum off that penalty kill? Riley Nash to the line, no further. It's a 1-1 tie. Jets scored early in the first. Hurricanes scored late in the first. Corvo for Dwyer. Dwyer's shot, that went wide. Dwyer goes after it. Watched by Bufflin and Bogosian. Gets it for Antropov, right wide for Kane. Kane with Corvo in pursuit. Kane wide, Kane around the net. Tried to bank this one off of Ward. And Cam Ward got that left pad down in time. Dwyer to center ice, no further, but it comes right back to him. He'll leave it for Wallace. Wallace is stopped by Postma. Antropov trying to jam it up the boards. Game two of a five-game road trip for the Jets. Continues in Philadelphia Saturday, Jersey Sunday. Postma for Kane, for Antropov, and he'll bounce it in. Jokinen goes after it. Jokinen watched by Jay Harrison. They battle in the corner. Dennis Mayak, Mike Johnson, our entire TSN Jets crew here in Carolina. Turned over. Kane goes after a loose puck. Dwyer couldn't track it down. It comes to center and Postma hammers it back into the Carolina end. Down the boards, Ryan Murphy couldn't trap it. Sent down low by Tangrady. Now Bermistra to the blue line for Bogosian. Bouncing puck, keeps it in. On the backhand, tried to get it to the front of the net, could not. Harrison clears it past Wellwood, a couple of former Leafs. And it's taken at center and flipped in by Andreas Nodal, the former Flyer. At center for Tangrady, the former Penguin. Cleared out through center. Here comes Jordan Staal. Well, let's finish that off. Another former Penguin. Taken at center, Bermistrov. Drafted by Atlanta. Now a member of the Winnipeg Jets, of course. Out at center ice, Westgaard. Kevin Westgaard will send it in. Pavlik trying to jam it away. Comes in behind the net. Controlled by the Hurricanes. Sanguinetti at the right point through some traffic to the far side boards. Westgarth is after it. Watched by Bogosian for Jordan Staal. Jordan Staal, Hainsey keeping an eye on him. Sanguinetti had it get away from him and Tangrady trying to bust down the left side. Gets it into the Carolina end and then sends it all the way around for Chris Thorburn. Jets are changing. Thorburn for Slater and he ripped that shot wide. Slater after it, Talusti plays it back into his own end. Gone over three without a whistle here in Carolina as they open it up. Right in for Thorburn and knocked off his stick. Good defensive play there by Sanguinetti. Now Wright is on it, tried to jam it to the front of the net, could not. Eric Staal loses it. James Wright to Slater, that's off a leg and wide. Thorburn centers to the line for Bufflin. Bufflin fires, and that gets blocked in front of the net, and that hurts Sanguinetti. Slater at center, back into his own zone for Grant Klitsam. 1-1 tie, both goals coming in the opening period. Wheeler early, Talusti late. Talusti trying to go cross ice, and that pass got picked off.
Can't force that one over to Semin there. He's got to take it all the way to the net. Good read by Bogosian, or by Bufflin to break it up.
Talusti, the left-hand shot coming down that right side, had the good angle. As you mentioned, tried to jam it through. Wheeler's on the loose puck. Snap a six-game goalless drought with his fifth goal of the season. In that opening period is Justin Falk. Plays for Corvo. And Corvo will send it in. Turning point of this period, the Jets down two men for 55 seconds. And for the first time in five attempts this year, kill off a 5-on-3. Wheeler in with Ladd. Ladd goes wide, puts it into the paint. Stopped there by Ward. After it, Thorburn for Little. Little for Stewart, who's back out. Shot by Stewart. Taken and held by Cam Ward. 1-1 here in the second period. Stewart back out for the Jets.
You want to know what it takes to kill 5-on-3 penalties. It takes a guy like Mark Stewart hanging in there on difficult situations, making good reads. I love this play off the faceoff. Most guys would drop off and go back into coverage, but he jumps on Justin Falk, throws him to the ground, gets the initial clear. That kills off about 20 seconds, and then this is not an easy thing to do. He hangs in there. You see him shake that one, catches him in the forearm. Doesn't go down, doesn't limp around, blocks another shot. gets off the bench, probably could get stitches if he needed to, bleeding pretty nicely there, but tapes it up right back on the ice, throwing in wristers from the blue line. That's the kind of guts it takes to kill penalties, and that's what Mark Stewart brings to the Jets lineup every night. He's sacrificing himself for the betterment of the team, and Andre Pavlik took notice of it, came over to the bench between commercial breaks there and sought Stewart out on the ice and gave him a little tap, said thank you very much, nice job.
Faceoff back in the Carolina zone, a 1-1 tie. Rob Millett with the tape job on Mark Stewart. And quick work today by the training staff, the medical staff of the Winnipeg Jets. The injury to Zach Redmond at this morning's skate. They were out there quickly. Anthony Peluso, who was on the ice at the time, some great work as well, applying pressure to the cut. In across the line as Hughes-Yoten carries in. Stick save there by Andre Pavlik. Taken on the far side, Harrison down low. After it is Jokinen. Ole Jokinen and Jussi Jokinen. Not related. In the slot, taken by Evander Kane. Kane couldn't get anywhere. Ole Jokinen for the Jets averages over a point a game career-wise against Carolina. Here's a sharp angle chance. That went wide. 57 points in 55 games for Ole Jokinen. Back into the Carolina end for Joe Corvo. Corvo on that right side for Wallace. Wallace will bounce it in, taken by Klitsam. Klitsam for Kane. Kane for Jokinen. Jokinen on that left side, long wrist shot. That went off a stick and sailed high. Dwyer plays it out for Jordan Staal. He'll send it in. Back into the Jets zone it goes. 24-year-old Jordan Staal in his seventh NHL season. Control at the line, wrist shot, that got blocked to the front of the net. Klitsam kicked it away. It bounces around. They bang at it off the blocker of Pavlik and taken by Chris Thorburn, and he'll get it up the center. Justin Falk, though, for Carolina, right back into the Jet zone. Pavlik will leave it for Buffett, and he'll play it for Klitsam. Klitsam's pass up the middle off a shin pad. Here comes Slater on the left side. Slater with 8 goals against Carolina, has 8 against Pittsburgh. Those are the teams that he has most of his NHL goals against. Here comes Slater. In across the line, Slater being watched by Ryan Murphy. The shot goes wide, kept in by Wheeler. Long shot stopped by Ward. Right behind the net, trying to get away from Harrison. And the pass right onto the stick of LaRose. LaRose to Kevin Westgaard. He is stopped at center, and Wheeler couldn't get to it before Riley Nash did, or Wheeler may have been off to the races. Pavlik around the glass. Ryan Murphy's going to hold it in, though. First NHL game for him. To the line, a low shot through traffic by Mikhail Jourdain, and that just missed. Little trying to get it through to Wheeler. They rule no icing as it went off a stick, and that will allow the Jets to get their change in. 1-1 tie, 6:12 to go here, second period. Little for Hainsey, and now delayed offside, and play is whistled down. Wheeler and Talusti in the first period, we have a 1-1 tie.
And yes, it is very early in the season, but it's not too early to start looking at the standings and realize the importance of inter-division matchup right now. The Carolina Hurricanes are in first place, third overall in the conference, 17 points. Winnipeg gets this game, all of a sudden only 2 points behind the current division leaders, and the Southeast has no one really running away with it. That might be Winnipeg's best opportunity to find the playoffs, is to actually win the division. And when you start looking at games like this, Dennis, it's not just about getting the win, but getting the win in regulation, making sure your opponent doesn't pick up any extra points along the way. And although we're only 15, 16 games in, we're also only 32 games remaining. So it's not too early to start looking.
Here comes Ole Jokinen. Coach Noel touched on that after the Buffalo win, how not only was it important to win, but do so in regulation because of what you just said. Around the boards for Semin. Semin plays it into the corner to the line. Does this come out? Yes, it does. And Harrison sends it back in, and faceoff will be at the Jets line.
Jay Harrison talked to him this morning about playing with Ryan Murphy in his first game, and he just said, well, I babysat Justin Falk all year last year. He turned out pretty well, so it should be just fine planning on talking a lot, cracking some jokes on the bench, just trying to keep it light. See him already right there, reaching over to him, talking about where he wants it to be, plays he wants it to make, and that's the veteran presence you need when you're breaking in a young guy. Understand what young players need to get through their first game and give it to them.
Buckland for Kyle Wellwood. Wellwood still looking for his first goal of the season. And Buckland's going to try it again. Jussi Jokinen in on him. Buckland's pass up the middle is picked off by Cormo. Hurricanes clear the zone and puts him behind his own net, getting pressured there by a couple of Hurricanes. Puts him twisting and turning, and on the other side, there to block him off was Nodal. Finally, puts him, does get it ahead. And Burmistrov's going to try and find some room again. The middle of the ice gets blocked off, and this is going to be an icing call. Bounce past a couple of Carolina Hurricanes, but the faceoff will come all the way back.
Winnipeg's got to find a way to get through that neutral zone you talk about, Dennis. Find a way to not skate it through because there's not enough room. Carolina checked too well, but you have to move it up the boards, get a chip, and flow to the puck so you can put some puck pressure on in the offensive zone. They're getting a little too stagnant, a little too spread out in the neutral zone. Without the puck support, keep turning it on, turning it over.
In off the far side glass, and Jets will start a line change. Hurricanes have to clear the zone. Klitsam, lead pass, and this is going to be another icing call unless Wheeler can get there first, but he can't. And the faceoff's going to come back, so the Jets are going to have to get this line change done in shifts.
That's the chip we were just talking about, except you have to get center ice before you get it. Blake Wheeler's got to get a little bit closer, but he at least was going to put some pressure on the puck in the offensive zone with his speed. And Tangrady's not happy with the icing call. It was a correct one, but 4 feet on the wrong side of the red line. We got a tired group right now. Burmistrov, the second time he's trying to make a change, he got called back on the ice, but he wins the draw. Allowed himself to get off.
So the draws in this game, 21-12, favoring Carolina with that last win by Burmistrov.
That's something you got to pay attention to. You get a sense of when you're down on the ice, and there's icing that up. You got to be a little bit more careful with the puck.
In across the line for Wheeler, puts it to the front of the net. Ladd was tied up. Good defensive play there by Harrison. Wheeler is on it. He had Stewart in the slot. It got tipped away, though. Now a penalty coming to the Carolina Hurricanes. Wheeler in for Little. Little to the back post. No one there, and Stewart jumps on it for Wheeler. Tried to get it back, and keeping an eye on that to see where the bank was going to come off those sideboards.
Watch the angle on that one. That would have been an own goal, to put it in soccer terms.
They seem like they take forever. It seems like double slow motion as they're making their way into the empty net.
Especially with the guy shooting it.
Jets power play when we come back to Carolina.
Jay Harrison into the box as he takes a penalty for the Carolina Hurricanes. Interference here. Andrew Ladd gets a stick up into him there. Leans on him, open hand. Not handling it, easy penalty to take, and compounds the problem right now because you have Falcon Corvo on the ice looking to kill the penalty. The next defenseman to come out, you have Sanguinetti, Murphy, and Jourdain. All rookies, none with experience, none considered to be defensive players. And that is the challenge that Dave Lewis has got to face with himself as they're deciding right now. You see the reaction of Kirk Muller's face as to what our next best option might be to get out there in a defensive pair.
Kirk Muller might be saying to Dave Lewis, how quickly can you get dressed? Hey, long-time defenseman.
Might be wanting to say, hey, Justin, play the whole 2 minutes if you can. Joe Corvo, stay out there if you can.
Postma for Wheeler. Wheeler goes cross ice for Klitsam. Klitsam to the front of the net off the stick. Wheeler's after it. All the way back to the point. Klitsam's going to hold it in. Quickly on Klitsam is Dwyer. Corvo there as well. Stahl is there. And it's clear to center. Postma. For Klitsam and back for Paul Postma. He'll leave for Burmistrov. Out there with Kane. Kane back into the middle of the ice. Jets going after it. Kane trying to block it off the boards. Can't. And it's back into the Jet zone where Burmistrov turns it up ice quickly. To the line. Burmistrov splits and gets tripped up. And now the Jets will have a 5-on-3.
That's a Tough one to take. Joe Corvo getting the trip on Burmistrov. Circles through the offensive zone, tacks him one-on-one, and Burmistrov so slick with the puck. Look at the lateral move here, and he absolutely does get it up into his legs there. Right into the skate, Burmistrov goes down, and we saw the Jets kill off a 5-on-3. Now calling a timeout, resting up their guys, diagramming a play so that they can try to capitalize on a 5-on-3. They have a full minute and 10 seconds to set something up and get it done.
And Mike, back to what you were saying before, now two veteran defensemen in the penalty box for Carolina.
Well, you're obviously going to be looking to do, well, you got Sanguinetti and Falk out there, with Eric Staal. You almost think with the personnel available, he might go two forwards and one defenseman. And I'm talking about Falk like he is a 10-year vet. He is far from it, very young on his own. But well, that is a responsibility he's got to carry for this group.
McBain, Gleason, and Pitkinen all out of the lineup because of injuries. Tim Brent is out of the lineup as well, and this is where Tim Brent would be on the ice.
You're talking about penalty killers, all of them.
So the Jets with their second two-man advantage of the season. They failed to score on their first one, and this one is going to be kept in by Bogosian. Bufflin off the sideboards for Bogosian. Cross ice, Jokinen for Ladd. Jokinen, Bogosian, Jokinen, Little. Cross ice looking for Ladd. Jokinen right in the slot, doesn't fire it. Down for Ladd. Bufflin is in front. Bogosian slap shot off the post. Bogosian controls, walks in, fires. Oh, and going down to block that one, and that hurt with Sanguinetti. Well, another defenseman is gone.
My goodness, talk about Mark Stewart sacrificing 5-on-3. Same thing, that is Bogosian right down the pipe, teeing it up, and he drops in front of it, right, takes him the foot.
Ladd, waiting for it, come off the boards, to the line for Bogosian. Over for Jokinen. 15 seconds, Jokinen fires, and he fired it wide. Bogosian for Little, he'll let it go to Bufflin, but Bufflin lost his footing. Into the slot, Jokinen couldn't fire it. Taken by Justin Falk, and he'll clear it into the Carolina bench. And that's going to bring the faceoffs back deep into the Carolina zone.
And they had some opportunities at 5-on-3. Bogosian teeing up a one-timer. Ding dong, there it goes, beating Cam Ward short side but not the post. And then look at this. This is an awful spot for Sanguinetti. Bogosian can bring it 100 miles an hour, and he puts it right into his group. And listen to what Cam Ward's dealing with. He's up on his toes, well out of his crouch. He's trying to peek over Bufflin's shoulder. He can't see a thing around Dustin Bufflin. You can see why he'd be so effective, and he's had enough of that. This is a chop to the midsection. But you see the problems that Bufflin causes goaltenders when he gets down in front of that. He's so big and wide that Cam Ward has to pull himself way out of his natural stance to find the puck around him.
That's the way it has been going for Ole Jokinen, with a great chance in the slot with Bufflin right in front and drilled it wide of the net. So one penalty is over as Harrison is back on the ice. So neither team able to capitalize on a two-man advantage here in this second period. Blitzum. For Evander Kane, he's forced to put on the brakes against the checking of Dwyer. Now Kane dances his way in on that right side as he gets around Staal. Can't get around the defenseman Harrison, and it's cleared to center. Wheeler back in with some speed. He gets tripped up, kept in at the line by Klitsam, but his pass misses Postma, and Postma has to backtrack. Postma gets tied up there by Jordan Staal. Antropov for Evander Kane, and back for Antropov. 35 seconds in the period. Near side boards to the line. Kept in there by Kane with some help from Thorburn, and now it's cleared over the glass, but they say this is off a stick. There will not be a penalty to Carolina.
Just a puck up and off the glass. He needs a break. That's a tired group. And Evander Kane has been very quiet tonight. He's showing some signs of some frustration, just not getting anything going. You see the body language on the bench. He's just not found any open ice, any time for him to open up his speed game. Carolina's done a good job of making sure they keep him contained.
Jets attempted five shots on those power plays. Not one was Cam Ward forced to make a save. Two were blocked, three missed the net. As the Jets, one of the top teams in the NHL, but not a category you want to be a top team in, and that is missed shots on goal. In behind the Jets net, Hainsey is after it. Hainsey clears for Slater. Slater is stopped. Unable to find some room on that right side with Semin. And the second period comes to an end. And Mike, both teams with a 5-on-3, and neither team able to capitalize. 18-14, the shots after two periods. Andre Pavlik has been very... No scoring in that second period. There's your shots on goal. The Carolina Hurricanes ahead in that category by four. Both goals coming in the opening period. Obviously, Blake Wheeler's fifth, Yuri Tolusti's sixth, and that's the way we stand as we get set to start the third.
It's been a defensive game, Dennis, so you think the defensive players would come to the forefront. Mark Stewart has certainly been that for the Jets. Been involved physically, tremendous on the penalty kill as he is most nights. And this is his kind of game, not a lot of space, lots of hitting, lots of mucking and grinding. And this is a big period for the Jets, where they are in the standings. These are the games they could not find a way to get last year on the road. They couldn't get the big goal when they needed it, couldn't close a game out, maybe they didn't play their best. Big opportunity here.
Mike, you were talking about faceoffs and guys getting tossed. Eric Stone tossed out of that faceoff circle at center ice as the two captains were facing off against each other. Two captains, by the way, that lead their respective teams in goals with eight each. Here comes the Carolina captain, Eric Staal, fired that one wide. Kept in by Justin Falk, back for Eric Staal, jumped over his stick. Keeping it at the line, though, was Corvo. Back for Eric Staal, sharp angle chance. And that sailed high and over top the net and all the way back around for Blake Wheeler. Wheeler into the slot for Ladd, and he gets dumped after the first shot didn't get through. Little for Ladd, for Wheeler, watched by Corvo. Wheeler to the blue line. Bogosian fires, and Cam Ward makes the save and hangs on. Bogosian, by the way, wearing number 44, wanted 44 when he joined Atlanta. Wore it through the training camp. They go to Detroit for a preseason game. They forget his jersey. So he has to wear number 4. And then when they move to Winnipeg, he doesn't have a contract, so he couldn't change his number to 44. And then finally, this year, was able to get his number 44.
Well, that's nice. Forgetting the jersey. Well yep. done. That's what happens at training camp. A lot of bodies flying around.
Yep. Wellwood trying to get this back to the line. Eric Staal, Jordan Staal, sends it back in behind his own net, and Ryan Murphy gathers it in. Grayson Bowman takes the pass, finds Jordan Staal. He gets rubbed out by Klitsam. Bowman to the backboards. Watched by Bufflin. Staal into the slot. Quick shot there by Dwyer. Kicked away by Andre Pavlik. Dwyer didn't get that one away as quickly as he would have liked to. Dwyer back on it, watched there by Bufflin, and Bufflin with the outlet pass for Wellwood. He'll leave for Jokinen, and Jokinen swings for Klitsam, and he'll bounce this into the Carolina zone. Back for a 10, Grady. Harrison is on it, tried to clear it up, and hits a stanchion. Ends up on the stick of Dwyer. For Jordan Staal, he'll slow it down and gently slide this into the Jet zone. Staal is after Bufflin. Bufflin chips against the traffic. Postma gets tripped up on the play. Turnover there, play goes on, and it's off the boards and out the center.
That's a good no-call. Postma's not helping himself there. Spinning out.
Kane feeds it for Vermeestroff. It's off his stick. Now it's turned over to Antropov, and he had trouble controlling it. And now the Hurricanes are upset. There was no penalty. Sharp angle. Chance score! Evander Kane! A quick release, and the Jets, early in the third period, have a one-goal lead. It's 2-1.
Evander Kane from a bad angle. It's lots of velocity on it, but the complaint will be right here. Nick Antropov turns it over, gets a stick out there on Wallace. Nice look, trying to find it all the way down there. Kane just wheels and fires, and Cam Ward just gets lost in the shuffle here. This is the one, Carolina. That's one that looks like a trip to me. Jets get away with it, and Evander Kane makes the pay with a wrister. Just, I think he caught Corvo's leg, switched angles on Cam Ward, thought it was going far side, ended up going short side. And Evander Kane has had a frustrating night so far. Gets the go-ahead goal.
Fifth of the year for Kane. He extends his point streak to 5 with 2 goals and 3 assists in that 5-game stretch. And the Jets with the 2-1 lead here in the third. Postma gets spun around. It's jammed to the side of the net. Pavlik is down. It never did get to the front. Nick Antropov, the only assist. Jets trying to get it out of their own end. And finally, it's out the center ice and flipped in by James Wright. Slater goes in after it. Slater drops for Thorburn. Thorburn trying to get it back to Slater, picked off by Jourdain. Now it's turned over, and James Wright keeps it in the Carolina zone. Westgaard over from Los Angeles earlier this season for Chad LaRose, and LaRose will send it in. Ron Hainsey back for it. 6'3", 210, 31 years of age. Hainsey sends it to the Carolina blue line. Little tracks it down for Ladd. Sharp angle. Ward down, makes the save. Bouncing puck at center, grabbed off by Jiří Tlusti. He has the Hurricanes goal in this game. It came late in the opening period. To the blue line, but gobbled up, and the Jets start back with Ladd. Cross ice feed, trying to spring Wheeler. Corvo breaks it up. Back for Semin. Semin cross ice. Falk steps into it, saved by Andre Pavlik. And he'll hang on as Semin with the nice feed for Falk.
Nice save on Justin Falk for Andre Pavlik. Turnover in the new. Look at this pass by Semin, though. How about the vision? Justin Falk coming off the bench. Barely gets the blue line. He lays it just the right time. Pavlik makes a good save. And here's Evander Kane. He's looking to find that one-timer deflection. And this puck definitely gets a piece of Joe Corvo's foot. But it's the kind of break the Jets will take right now. They haven't had much going in the offensive zone, but keep putting pucks on the net, getting the crazy bounce. And now they've got the lead in the third period.
Three goals in the six-game series between these two teams last year for Evander Kane. The Jets won four of the six. They won two at MTS Center, and they won two in this building. Shot off the line, rebound, score! Pavlik got a piece of it, not enough, and Jordan Staal ties the game.
Well, we've made reference to the face-off battle, which has hardly been a battle. It's been all Carolina tonight. Jordan Staal wins another one. Puck hits him and Jim Slater on the way to the net, and he just wheels and fires it. But you can only lose so many defensive zone face-offs throughout the course of a game, and it's a bouncer. That's a tough spay for Andre Pavlik as he takes that rolling puck, rolls his wrist over to make sure it doesn't get away from him, drives it into the ice, bounces back up over Pavlik's pad. But it all starts with the faceoff win, puck support on the wall. And the Jets have put themselves in trouble, losing all those draws throughout the night. Finally comes back with a goal against.
A minute 27 between the two goals after Evander Kane gave the Jets the lead. Jordan Staal has tied this thing up. And for Jordan Staal, his third of the season.
Another one of the reasons they got him. He's a big guy. He's good on faceoffs. And he can lean on people. Jim Slater is out going against him on the faceoff. He's bigger than him. He shoves it over the board. Drayson Bowman helps with the chip back. Seals Slater off in front of the net. And then just puts it on Pavlik. And you can already see the respect they have for him wearing the A, which is rare for someone so new to a team.
Jordan Staal, 6'4", 220. Eric is also 6'4", just not as heavy as Jordan. He checks in at 205. Far side for Evander Kane. Harrison and Dwyer with the assists on the goal. Antropov on the backhand, back into the Carolina zone. Ryan Murphy to the backboards with Evander Kane. Cleared on the left side for Drayson Bowman. Bowman through the middle of Ryan Murphy. Murphy with some speed into the Jet zone. Tried to get it to the front of the net. Dwyer knocked Postma down. And the puck taken by Kane. Out to center, no further. And Dwyer will take over. 2-2 tie here in the third. Snapped in by Jordan Staal. Pavlik leaves it behind the net. Bufflin plays it ahead for Jokinen. Jokinen through the middle. Sends it on for Tangrady. Eric Tangrady with Jokinen heading to the front of the net. Now takes the pass behind. Tried to find Wellwood. Does! Shot. That may have been stopped before it got to Ward. Now a blast from the left point by Klitsam. Goes off a body and up and out of play.
We'll take another look at this Jordan Staal goal here, the game tying goal. Puck's loose, it's rolling there. He looks to roll it over and it bounces below. It doesn't hit Slater's stick, hits the ice below, it bounces back up. And what a tough read. Pavlik's got the ice sealed pad down, and it just drives in, takes a funny skip, bounces up and over, and tough puck for Pavlik to try to get a hold of, and he couldn't do it.
Lead pass for Wellwood, too far. You take away the empty net goal by Craig Adams. The last seven games the Jets have been in have been one goal games, so this shouldn't be a surprise that we're tied 2-2 here in the third. Kraft Hockey goes on as awarding $1 million to minor hockey associations across Canada. Visit krafthockeygoeson.ca. Nominate a hockey volunteer from your community. Eric Staal wins the draw. Simon, the quick shot. That looked like it changed directions. And another faceoff win by Carolina. Jay Harrison back into his own zone. Harrison tried to slow up and up for an icing call, but it got waved off. Now it gets turned over. Centered out front. That's off a skate. Wheeler goes after it. Blake Wheeler back down low to Ladd. Ladd looking to the blue line. He'll find Hainsey. Hainsey looking off the back post for Wheeler, but it got deflected away. Wheeler stays on the loose puck. Tries to spin it down to Brian Little. Little in a battle in the corner with Eric Staal. And it's around for Ryan Murphy, and he'll find some room. Ryan Murphy with some speed. Murphy in his first NHL game. Sharp angle shot high to the short side. But Pavlik makes the save on the chance by Ryan Murphy. Face off in the Jets zone. Another face-off. Carolina has won 62% of the face-offs in this game. 6 of 8 here in the third period, including the one that led to the game-tying goal. And they win another one. Andreas Nodal. Slater's on him quickly. Nodal for behind the net, looking, trying to get this one onto the stick of Wallace. That doesn't work. And Jokinen sends it cross ice, and that ends up in the Carolina bench.
It's okay to turn the puck hard as the Carolina bench is, everyone's aware, making sure that I was bailing out, of course, and they makes the save on Nolan Jokinen. That's okay, not over the glass, no penalty to be had, but I like the way the Jets have really used that net front presence on their breakouts, popping that little loose puck. That's where the space is. Everyone takes the board away, pressure down the boards, and you pop it to the front of the net. There's opportunities to be had.
I think backup goaltender Dan Ellis had you covered there anyway. That glove would have come out quickly.
Yeah, he's been protecting me all night.
After it goes Evander Kane. Interesting, both Dan Ellis and Cam Ward born in Saskatoon, so Saskatoon well represented in this game because James Wright is also born in Saskatoon. On the far side for Jordan Staal. To center, winds his way through, gets rubbed out there by Klitsam, keeps on going, and a save on the short side by Andre Pavlik.
And you're getting a little taste of the size and strength of Jordan Staal in this third period. Grant Klitsam has a good angle, rubs him out, gets a good piece of the body there. He just shrugs him off, blows right through the check, takes it in the net. Andre Pavlik does a nice job here. Klitsam's got him right where he wants him. Takes him in the center of the body. He's got to probably get a little bit lower. You can't take Jordan Staal up high. You got to get down even lower into his thighs and hips. And Jordan Staal throwing a little dash there.
Jokingly, in a question that we didn't expect an answer to, we asked Jordan Staal what made him happier on his wedding day, his wedding or finding out that he was going to play with his brother, and he just smiled and walked away. So
it's a bit of a loaded question there.
Yeah, we didn't expect an answer. We didn't get one. That was a good day for him.
It's a heck of a day, though.
You bet.
Life altering in so many ways.
Yeah. You got a great wedding gift from the Pittsburgh Penguins. Mm. And in various ways. One, he was playing with his brother. And secondly, he was kind of stuck in a third-line center role in Pittsburgh. Eric Staal gets stopped there by Blake Wheeler. Wheeler ahead for Ladd with Little. Possible odd man rush. Getting back is Talusti. Little the shot, and that's off a skate. Wheeler tried to drag it to the front. Stopped by Ward. Off a skate. And to the far corner it goes. Semin lifts this out to center ice. Where is it? Finally comes down right about the dot. Taken by Corvo, and he'll swing it back into his own zone as both teams start a change. Lead pass misses everyone. Back forward Postma. This will be icing called against Carolina.
Carolina's been very disciplined with the puck tonight. Not giving up a lot, many turnovers, but they have one here, and it's a rare 3-on-2 break. Ladd, Little, and Wheeler taken off. Wheeler hits a little on the stop up. Puck's blocked, but Wheeler almost gets a chance. Nice job by both Ladd and Wheeler stopping around the net, not flying by, not curling to the corner, but sticking around there while it was the Carolina Hurricanes defensemen that were turning off.
To the front of the net, cleared away, and Wellwood is on it. Wellwood for Burmistrov. Kane waiting for it as well. Back for Burmistrov. Wellwood is on the loose puck. Wellwood trying to get it to the net, could not. Postma sends it down low. Wellwood on this line now in place of Nick Antropov. Postma trying to hold it in, could not. Quickly up, Stewart for Burmistrov. He lets the shot go, that's off a leg. Stewart tees it up from the line. Doesn't get much on it as his stick shatters. Unable to pick up a stick as he went by the bench, and here comes Stahl. Cross ice, but that was into the skates and right back for the Jets. Room down the left side for Kane with Wellwood. Kane into the slot, pulls it, fired left side, missed the net. Slater's on it. Behind the net for Kane, off his stick. And taken by Drayson Bowman. Bowman with a little bit of room, gathers some speed, but he's poke checked at the line. Ryan Murphy for Jay Harrison. 11 to go in the third period of a tie game. Two goals in the first, two goals here in the third. Wave off the icing and back for Dustin Byfuglien. Hurricanes again sending two men in. Dwyer falls, kept in there by Eric Stahl. And then on a second attempt, it will be cleared to center. Fired back in, Byfuglien waits for it to come off the corner boards. And the Hurricanes start another chain. Byfuglien on the right side, getting knocked down in the neutral zone with Slater. And back comes Eric Stahl as the Hurricanes now double shifting that top line of Telusti, Semin, and Eric Stahl. Room down the left wing for Slater, fanned on the shot. Behind the net for James Wright. Wright trying to jam it up front. He got stopped by Sanguinetti. At the line for Bogosian, that shot hit Wheeler. Justin Falk slaps it off the boards and back into the Winnipeg zone. Hainsey goes back for it, and they are going to call this icing. And the faceoff comes back into the Carolina zone.
A little housekeeping here at the bench because there was a wholesale line change going on. Trying to sort out exactly who was on, who was not. An eventual shift for Burmistrov. He takes a pretty solid, clean hit from Nodal. And then he recognized Stewart's got no stick. He needs some help with Jordan Stahl. And this is probably not how you teach it exactly. Could off definitely be called a hook, but he gets away with it and helps stop the rush.
Eric Stahl. Nice spinorama and an outlet pass for Telusti. Telusti will send it deep, and then that top line for Carolina heads to the bench. Brian Little. Through the center ice area, Little into the Carolina end. Stuck. Puck gets off his stick, but he holds it in. Now to Wheeler. Wheeler down low. Ladd looking for some open ice. Cross ice pass intended for Ladd. Got deflected away. At the line, Byfuglien off the side of the goal. Wheeler to the far side corner with Jay Harrison. Harrison for Jordan Stahl. He'll send it to center. Byfuglien puts it right back into the Carolina end. Ryan Murphy slowly gets to center, hammers it in. Pavlik steers it away, Klitson's on the loose puck, and sends this back, and they wave off the icing as back forward goes Joe Corvo.
In a sense, both teams realize where they are in the game and the score, and an already conservative game has gotten even a little bit more cautious.
At center for Corvo, sends it in, and Klitson is the first man back. Klitson gets bumped hard there by Wallace. Antropov is on it. Antropov for Klitson. He'll play it back into his own end for Dustin Byfuglien.
I'm sure Klitson knew that that was not going to be an icing. He eased up there, and Wallace certainly did not.
Cleared in after it goes Tangrady. Jokinen, Antropov, and Tangrady. Now the line for Claude Noel. Antropov at center redirects. Here comes Jokinen. And offside called against the Jets at the Carolina line. 2-2 tie, 8:15 to go. Tampa Bay in action tonight, trailing Boston 3-2, and Tampa Bay That action on Sunday, the NHL on TSN continues. Tampa Bay in Pittsburgh to take on the Penguins. Live coverage begins at 6:30 Central on TSN 2 and TSN Mobile TV.
Claude Noel making some notes heading down the stretch here, and he's starting to think about line combinations, making sure to have two centermen out for defensive zone draws, and you want to get the point. The 2 points in regulation. You don't want to give Carolina a point out of this, but at the same time, you want to make sure that you get yours. So that's a fine line. The players are walking. The posts are walking. How much do they press to make sure they get two in regulation, and how much do they make sure to get the one and then just take their chances in overtime?
Jets riding a two-game road winning streak. 1-0 in Ottawa and then 2-1 in Buffalo, and have themselves in a 2-2 tie here with 8 minutes to go in the third. Ryan Murphy takes a bump from Ryan Stewart, gets it in. Paul Postma goes after it, dodged to check. Bermistroff for Evander Kane. Kane couldn't handle it. And the Hurricanes take over. It is Alexander Semin trying to find an open man, can't. And the Jets will start back with Evander Kane. Kane gave the Jets a lead. Here's Kane trying to bust through. He gets tied up and goes sliding into Cam Ward. Wellwood is on the puck. Back to the line for Stewart. Now the Postma walks in, fires right on. Cam Ward way out, thought he had it. And the puck in the corner and cleared out to center ice quickly. Taken there by Jokinen, long wrist shot, that sailed high and wide. Stewart spins Jussi Jokinen around. Wellwood is on the puck. Lost it, gets it back. In for Wright for Slater. Back for James Wright. Thorburn headed to the high slot. Slater puts it to the side of the net. Cleared away quickly by Falk. Hainsey is on it. Plays it all the way around the boards. Bogosian was going to pinch and then backtracks, and way in behind everybody was Alexander Semin. Hainsey closed in on him, but Semin gets the puck for Stahl at the line. Corvo sends it back in behind the net. Hainsey with Semin after him. Hainsey will get it to Slater. Bank pass looking for Wright. Bounces at the Carolina blue line. Hurricanes are changing. Semin takes the pass from Eric Stahl. Semin drills that one from the line. And a save made by Pavlik.
The goaltender duel tonight. Pavlik with a good save. Evander Kane forcing Cam Ward for a good one. Ryan Murphy's had a good game, but you can take advantage of him a couple times. It's a hard move laterally. The size and reach of Kane and the nice quick release. That is fantastic stuff. But Cam Ward, when he's on top of his game, he loves being aggressive, way outside his crease, challenging Postma, make sure there's no angle. And Andre Pavlik fights that one off as it was buzzing by his ear from Semin.
Not dressed for the Jets tonight, Anthony Peluso, Antti Miettinen, who is close to returning. Toby Enstrom still out, and of course, the injury this morning at the morning skate to Zach Redmond. Harrison, 3 hours of surgery, by the way, for Zach Redmond. The right femoral artery and vein, as he got stepped on at a drill this morning at the morning skate, is okay. There's going to be an icing call here as Grant Klitsam goes back to touch the puck.
It's good news, obviously, about Zach Redmond after the fortunate freak accident in the morning skate. Claude Noel knew his team was going to be in tough. He knew that. You can say all the right things and hope for all the right things, but it's a human reaction to a friend being injured.
Bouncing puck for Andrew Ladd, scores! Andrew Ladd right off the faceoff, a puck that Cam Ward had trouble handling, and Andrew Ladd has his ninth of the year, and the Jets have a lead.
Andrew Ladd right on the spot, as this is a faceoff that is actually won cleanly by Jordan Stahl all the way into Cam Ward. Jay Harrison was jumping into the faceoff circle to try to help on the scramble, leaving Andrew Ladd the free path to the net. And we've talked so much about icing tonight and faceoffs and the Jets losing those faceoffs. Well, they created icing, but they still lose the draw, but it works out for Andrew Ladd as he does the right thing, jumps to the net. And in his 500th game in Carolina, the team that drafted him, he has the goal late to put the Jets up by one.
The team that he won a Stanley Cup with was here for 3 years before he got moved on to Chicago to win another Stanley Cup. So Andrew Ladd has the Jets in front by one. Stewart, watched by Jokinen, back to the line for Falk. He'll play it for Sanguinetti. Into the slot, jammed away, but Sanguinetti has it again. Rifles it to the front of the net. Brian Little with the assist on the goal by Ladd. Sanguinetti through the middle, almost room there. And then Wallace lays a bit of lumber on Paul Postman. Evander Kane in his own end. Kane gets double teamed as the Hurricanes press. Here comes Toulouse, he scores! Hurricanes come right back. And their hottest scorer as of late, Jiří Toulouse, ties the game 47 seconds after Andrew Ladd gave the Jets the lead.
The response has been there a couple times. Evander Kane battling for the puck, just can't quite get it out. Crazy bounce, and Toulouse picks it up with a little bit of momentum heading forward. Dancing through the coverage. Kane here, he's trying to find a way. It's sealed off on the boards, and Jokinen caught standing still, right spinning, and that's a nice set of hands for Toulouse though. Dancing through there in traffic, and the quick release, good shot. Just above the pad, below the blocker, Andre Pavlik. We're just trying to get into the importance of the Jets to have these follow-up shifts to sustain momentum and positivity after they scored a goal, and now twice in this third period it hasn't happened.
And again, a turnover. Here's a chance for Wheeler and a low. Wheeler scores! Blake Wheeler! There's a response from the Jets. His second of the game, and the Jets are back in front.
Back and forth we go, as Blake Wheeler gets one right after Toulouse had tied it right from behind the net here. Play is made as Andrew Ladd looks to flip this one to space. Joe Corpo sells out trying to catch that puck. If he gets it, the play's broken, he misses it. It's a breakaway. Well, he misses it. Blake Wheeler stays onside, and Cam Moore guesses wrong here. He's kicking that left foot out thinking Wheeler's going low. Glove side. Wheeler goes five hole, and there's all kinds of room between the legs of Cam Ward. And that is a blown defensive assignment. Joe Corbo, veteran player, has to realize the speed of Wheeler. Can't let him get him behind him there. And if you do, if he does, you can't look for the...
16 seconds between the goal by Toulouse and the go-ahead goal by Wheeler. We're just getting warmed up for Philadelphia.
Coach, players like it. Coaches don't like this at all, though.
This has been wild. 4-3 Jets. A minute and three between the three. Long bouncer in on Pavlik. He had to be careful with that one.
And that's after going long stretches in this game, Dennis, where there has been not many good offensive opportunities.
Cleared in by Sanguinetti. After it is Bufflin. Bufflin will play it for Klitsam. Klitsam will lift this high in the air. And Justin Falk will knock it down. Bufflin knocks it down at center. Off of Bufflin's glove to Eric Staal, so play allowed to continue. And the Hurricanes control with under four to go and a one-goal Jets lead. This is going to be icing, but Eric Staal gets there first. Now he's stopped by Bogosian. Kane to the far side, boards with Falk. In behind, taken by Bogosian. Puts on the brakes, tight turns to get away from Toulouse. Two in the game for Toulouse, two in the game for Blake Wheeler. Bounce to the line, but not out. And now on a second try, Kane will get it out the center. Right back in for Toulouse, though. Tried to get it to Eric Staal. That got stopped, and James Wright is on it. Wright tried to clear it up. The boards could not. They pile in. Harrison couldn't keep it in. Here comes Kane. Kane trying to get around Ryan Murphy as the youngster's out there with 3 minutes to go in a one-goal game. At the line, Bufflin will just flip this in behind the Carolina net. Wheeler pours in after it. Now to Little. Back in deep, taken by Jordan Staal. Out to center for Jordan Staal. That's as far as he gets. And it's put back in. Ladd and Little on the assists on the goal by Wheeler. Grayson Bowman plays this around the boards. It comes all the way out to center. So a two-point game for Ladd, two-point game for Little. This line was good in Buffalo on Tuesday. In behind the net. Taken by Jordan Staal. Into the slot. Corbo the shot. And Andre Pavlik makes a glove save and hangs on. And now we've got a little extracurricular activity in front of Andre Pavlik. It's been wild. Five goals here in the third period. Jets up by one.
Blake Wheeler probably had his strongest game of the season against Buffalo last game. Was not rewarded with any points on the scoreboard, but tonight he's carried that effort over and he's gotten the results early in the first period. Again, using his speed to create his space. When he's at his best, that's what he does. Long wrister off the post, and then again, using his speed, forcing Joe Corbin to a bad decision. Good finish on the breakaway. That is the Blake Wheeler that the Winnipeg Jets need and that he can bring every night. When he's skating with his size and his reach, he's a very, very difficult man to cover.
Two on the night for him. Give him six on the season. Slater, who will be called on big time to win some faceoffs down the stretch. 7 goals in 6 games for Yuri Tolusti. 7 goals in 9 games for Andrew Ladd. And both Stahl and Slater are... Linesman's had about enough of them. Kicks them both out.
Well, Noel, two centermen on the ice, though.
And the Jets win the draw. Brian Little winning it out to the line. Corbel trying to hold it in. Can't. Slater to the Carolina blue line. It goes high in the air and cleared there by Falk.
Now Slater's got to get off, get Ladd on the ice, and get his rest for this next defensive zone faceoff.
Off of Ron Hainsey and fanning on it with Semin. Back down the ice, odd man rush, Brian Little. In with Wheeler, across to Wheeler and tipped away. Great defensive play there by Justin Falk as Wheeler was looking for his second career hat trick. Tolusti, rink wide for Semin. Into the jet zone after it, Zach Bogosian. After him is Eric Stahl. Tolusti trying to work it up front. The pass was blocked. Bogosian for Antropov. It's off a skate and in. Back into his own end, Ryan Murphy. With under a minute and a half, we'll keep an eye on Cam Ward. Jokinen at center, stops Eric Stahl. Jokinen plays it back. There's a penalty coming to the Carolina Hurricanes. Eric Stahl's going to go for dumping Jokinen at center ice. In on that left side. Right plays it for Antropov, for Tangrady rather, for Antropov. At the line, shot, and that hit Jokinen in front. Back to the right point, and this is going to be picked off by Jokinen. And a hooking call will give the Jets a power play with 57.4 seconds to go.
Jordan Stahl off for the hook. Good call in the neutral zone. He's frustrated and disappointed, but Ole Jokinen protects the puck. That first one's okay. It's this next one here. Under the arms when he's lost body position. Good strength by Ole Jokinen on the puck in the neutral zone to draw that penalty. And now less than a minute left. They have the power play. Offensive zone faceoff. Timeout. Carolina trying to rest their guys for this last little push where Cam Ward will come out as soon as they clear the zone.
4-3 in favor of the Jets. Let's go back to your game plan back in the opening period, Michael.
For the Jets, we wanted to make sure that they turned the Carolina defensemen, make them turn, make them get back to their own end. They've done a pretty good job of it when they can. They haven't had a ton of sustained pressure, but they've been disciplined because of their discipline. They haven't given up too much speed through the neutral zone. And the tight checking game with less free-flowing activity is better suited for the Jets than it is for Kirk Muller's team. And because of that, we find the Jets up one with less than a minute to go on the power play.
Power play 0 for 16 now in the last 7 games, but I don't think scoring a power play goal is all that important for them right now. It is preventing the Carolina Hurricanes from getting into your end of the ice and getting their netminder out. Little. And after the penalty against Jordan Stahl, Eric Stahl getting a 10-minute misconduct. So they will miss him. Lead pass for Yuri Tolusti. That got picked off and cleared back down the ice. The Jets trying to finish this one off in a wild third period. Wheeler breaks it up. Wheeler sends it down low. Wheeler carries short side, high shot, batted away. Around the boards, Ladd goes after it. The Jets so far not allowing Carolina to get the goaltender out. Now headed to the bench is Ward, but Semin is chased back into his own end by Bogosian. There's a lead pass broken up at center ice. Slater at the empty net, deflected away. Winnipeg Jets trying to run their road winning streak to 3. And one last chance, no. The Winnipeg Jets go 2-for-2 to start a five-game road trip as they defeat the Carolina Hurricanes 4-3 in a very tough and emotional day after what happened this morning at the morning skate with Zach Redmond. But they found a way. Wasn't their prettiest game of the year, Mike, but they found a way.
That's just it. Doesn't matter how they did it, they found a way. They weren't great early. Pavlik bailed them out when they needed a big goal. They were able to get one, even when they gave them right back. They kept on responding. Great resiliency for the Jets in, a team that's been playing pretty well.
So the Jets road record now 4-3-1. Lots to come on our post-game show, including Coach Noel.